Sharan stands for Sanctuary for Health and Reconnection to Animals and Nature. And the reason we are disconnected is because we live so far from nature and animals sometimes, and we have ideas that our culture has given to us. The very first thing our parents give us often is milk. For me, when I was a kid, I thought cow's milk was healthy. I had 3 glasses a day, and curds and buttermilk and so on and so forth. But certain things changed and my perspective changed, and I realized that we are doing things just because we have grown up doing things. All animals eat by instinct. They know what to fuel their body. If you see fruits or vegetables ripe and hanging there, what do you feel like doing?
Eating.
Plucking and eating, right? And this is instinct. Now, if you see a chicken walk by, does your mouth water? If you're a dog, you'll have the opposite reaction. You might chase the chicken, and then the orchards mean nothing to you, right? So this means something. Foods natural to our anatomy are fruits, vegetables, nuts, seeds. Manufacturers know this. That's why all the soaps and shampoos and body care products smell of fruits and flowers. Have you noticed? You don't find beef or chicken smelling shampoo, right? Being a doctor, suddenly the literature came in front of me and I realized that milk is not as good as I thought it was. For example, I understood that osteoporosis occurs in the countries with the largest consumption of milk. Actually, meat and milk have the same composition, high protein, high fat, and no fiber. And people who are vegetarian get the same diseases, asthma, obesity, the whole lot, as non-vegetarians. There's a big difference between animal fat and plant fat. And we are going to see what it does to our body later. So animal fat is solid at room temperature. Plant fat is liquid at room temperature. And this makes a huge difference in our body. We are going to see what exactly it does. But if you have all this solid fat going into your bloodstream, it behaves like Vaseline. And it really slows down your blood circulation. Obesity is also, of course, caused by fat without fiber. But if you're having coconut, you could eat all the coconut you wish. Because of the fiber, you won't get the obesity, because the fiber prevents you from overeating. Now let's understand a little bit about protein. It's a food for growth and repair. Do you know what is the maximum time of growth of a human being? When it's just born, a human baby doubles its weight in 6 months, triples its weight in 1 year. After that, do we ever double our weight in 6 months?
No.
Hopefully not, right? And they did a study and they found that if you consume more protein, you lose more calcium. The maximum calcium we need in our whole lifespan is soon after we're born. And human breast milk contains 33 milligrams per 100 grams. Cow's milk contains more, of course, because the calf has to grow faster. But all green leafy vegetables, nuts and seeds contain a lot more calcium than human milk. And even potato chips has more calcium than human milk. So a very good book to read is the China Study. It talks about how excess protein affects every system of our body. Your respiratory system, your circulatory system, your digestive system, your reproductive system, every system, your skeletal system, bones and muscles. Every system is adversely affected by excess protein. People who a non-vegetarian usually take in a lot of cholesterol every day compared to people who are vegan who take no cholesterol because there's no cholesterol in plants. Only vegans usually have the amount that we should have, which is 135 or so. Acidity. Many people have acidity, and that's because their stomach tries to produce acid to keep in pace with the protein we're eating. The minute you cut out the protein, acidity is gone. Kidney diseases. Whenever we eat acid foods, we are taking calcium out of the bones, and this goes through the kidneys and out, and that causes stones. So that's one thing that high protein or excess protein causes. But excess protein, especially animal protein, is like a toxin for the kidneys. And so if people have kidney disease, need dialysis, if we cut off all the animal protein, kidney disease becomes much better. Any foreign protein that comes into our body is supposed to produce antibodies. And the most common cases of type 1 diabetes are in people who have had cow's milk at too early an age instead of their mother's milk. So they produce antibodies to the cow's milk. And these antibodies destroy their pancreatic cells because cow's milk protein and pancreatic cells are very similar. And this causes type 1 diabetes. So today we are seeing all over the world, not just in India, more cases of thyroid deficiency, more cases of diabetes, more cases of problems which are hormonal problems. And these are because one of the causes can be hormone disruptors because of plastic everywhere.
Breast cancer is a hormone-dependent cancer, and we are getting hormones in excess with our milk consumption every day.
And milk samples in India contain PCBs. That's a breakdown of plastic. And even 85 kilos have been found in a live cow of plastics. And if you want to know more about this, there's a beautiful film called The Plastic Cow. Whole food. What is whole food? So basically, it's about eating foods as whole as a monkey would eat.
So it's better to have the whole fruit rather than fruit juice, for example. Why? Because we want to have all the fiber.
And so it means peel your bananas but not your apples, because monkey can't peel an apple. Monkey has, the only peeler the monkey has is his hands. And so we don't peel any vegetables except for onions and garlic, because that's the only thing a monkey could peel. And it means that monkey cannot eat oil, because monkey doesn't have machines. Monkey cannot eat sugar.
Has anyone tried eating sugar cane? Good. So you know that you can't get much beyond a piece this size, right?
I think so. When I was younger, I give you a little more, but...
Little more. Fine. Little more. But if you have sugarcane juice, you have three long ones going into one glass of juice. When you make it into jaggery, it's more sugar, right? So that's why we don't want to have sugar in jaggery, because we can have so much more when we take out the fiber. Actually, nature makes everything so well that, for example, some people ask me, coconut, isn't that heavy? How much coconut can I have? But if you sat with an open coconut, how much can you eat? You wouldn't go beyond one. Even half might be too much, right? So nature has all the stocks. And also, the nutrient value is much higher if you have whole foods. So this is a chart which shows what happens when whole wheat is refined to white flour. You lose 25% of the protein, 95% of the fiber, but you lose more than 50% of all the other nutrients. So if you eat brown rice, how much do you eat compared to white rice?
Less.
Less. How much less? 50% less, right? At least 50% less. That means you've had half the calories, more than double the nutrients, just by eating something whole.
If I say no more meat, no more eggs, no more milk, depending on what you're eating, can you see that it feels like, wow, that's tough? If I say no more carrots, no problem. No more peas, what's the problem? Right? And that's because there are certain foods that are addictive. And actually, milk has something in it called casomorphins. Casomorphins are morphine-like substances, and it's for the calf to get addicted to its mother. And we are addicted, we get addicted to milk. If I were to ask someone to stop smoking, they're going to have the same problem as if I were to ask you to stop having dairy, if you were having dairy. It's the same feeling. Oh my God, how can I live without it? But the important thing to realize is that we don't need any milk, because milk is the food for infants. If you want to have some milk on your muesli or coconut milk or so on, okay, fine. But we don't need any. The cow, just like any mother, is dying to be with her baby, and so is the baby. But the male calf goes for slaughter. That's where all the calf leather comes from. And the female leather, the female calf is given a little bit of her mother's milk, but most of the milk is sold to human beings. So, you know, basically, we are what we eat, and the feelings of those animals are transmitted to us. Their insecurity, their forsaken feeling, their fear, their despair. You know which is the sickest animal on the planet?
Human beings.
Close. Sicker than that? What could be sicker than a human being?
Cow.
Sicker than that?
Chicken.
It's the broiler chicken. The broiler chicken. And the broiler chicken is raised to grow to double the weight in half the time. And the egg-laying chickens are actually separated into males and females. The males are dumped, crushed up, and fed to their sisters because they don't lay eggs. The females, actually soon after they're born, their beak is sliced off with a hot iron. And that's because they're put into these kind of cages where, you know, they have no space to even lift their wings. 5 to 8 in a cage. And so their tendency in that frustration is to peck or claw. And so their claws are cut off, their beaks are cut off. These are the most sensitive parts of their body. And if you were to rescue them from that cage and put them in your backyard, they will die of a heart attack just by walking when they're 6 weeks old. That's their introduction to the world. But what about the ecological impact? Animals produce more greenhouse gases than all the vehicles on the planet. Wow. And this has a huge ecological impact on water, land, energy, air, food availability, everything. All these animals need water. All these animals take up a lot of land, way more, takes a lot more land to raise a cow than it does to raise a tree of fruit and get the same amount of food. And all these animals eat food which could be going to feed our millions who are starving every day. So, when you're trying to change, your mind will be saying pizza, 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 or chocolate, chocolate, whatever. But once you make the switch, that craving just goes away.
So it changes your whole perspective in a strange way, because you know, as long as we're consuming them, we have to justify this in our minds. And suddenly something changes. So people who made the change say that it was much easier to do than it seemed. And the results are so amazing that it helps keep you there. Of course, if you can't do everything, you can do one thing at a time and see what happens.
So, if you've been used to eating meat or a lot of dairy, then the first thing you want to do is replace it with beans, because beans are protein that will stay in your stomach for a long time and give you some sense of fullness, not as bad as meat, but it gives you a sense of fullness. And fruit is always a good thing to have for snacks, but you could also have nuts and seeds and dried fruits and things like that. And if you're getting more energetic, you can have a green smoothie. And so we have lots of transition foods that help you to make that switch. Like for example, today we are making a shepherd's pie with lentils, but there's a kind of cheese on top. And the cheese has been made with cashews. By the way, what does cheese smell like? Anybody smell cheese? Huh? Like the feet, yes, it smells like old socks. It really does. And how did we get addicted to eating something that smells of old socks? And that's why the vegan cheese is a little better. So you soak the cashews, then put them in the blender, very little or no water, and make it into a thick paste. And then cover it, put it in a glass container, and cover it with a cloth. And the cashews will ferment and start smelling a little bit sour. And that means your cheese is ready. All you have to do is add salt and it's done. So if you look on our website, under meat and dairy replacements, there's a whole section on what you can replace for egg. In the past, when they weren't doing factory farming, nobody ever used eggs and cakes because it's a waste of an egg. But how do you make the cake rise so nicely without any eggs? You put a little bit of vinegar and a little bit of baking soda, and it all effervesces and you get a nice light cake. So vegan cakes, no problem at all.
Your loving kisses.